is the key here. Geraldon will determine, and we actually see Geraldon attach pass.
Wow, what a way to open up our Masters Finals here. Ian Robb, no Arceus V Insight, just that energy on that Duraludon V and Cyrus top decks, that battle VIP pass, the best card to have on your opening turn.
Indeed, you can see the big smile on her face. She celebrated as well at Ian's low start. What a turn of events that Geraldon VMAX evolving would be a big deterrent for Cyrus, but no Arceus, no attachments. That is what you want to see right here.
I guess the one good news is you can get that evolution in play. Double Gunner's not really going to be able to hit that active. It only hits the bench with those two damage counters to two Pokemon. So that's going to put a lot of pressure on Cyrus to actually get a fast start here.
Oh, certainly. And I love the double Remoraid here. Finding those specific cards with Octillery is going to be very key to Cyrus's strategy, being able to get out those multiple Inteleon VMAXs, get a lot of those pieces to start damaging. And here we see the Force Heal Stone getting us potentially a second Battle VIP pass, potentially a supporter, perhaps, like an Irida that could get you a Water-type Pokémon and the Battle VIP itself. We'll have to see what happens here.
Looks like Cyrus is eyeing down that Irida, that Battle VIP pass, that Inteleon V. Irida really is just a supporter that can get you anything you want.
Yeah, Irida is such a good card for water types. We all expected Irida to be played heavily at this tournament with the release of Baxcalibur and Xianpao, but no one would have thought it would be in the finals in a deck with Inteleon VMAX.
Who would have thought? Not me.
Not me either.
Battle VIP pass does grab a second Inteleon V and that Radiant Alakazam. This has been a Radiant that has really increased its value in a lot of these decks in this Paldea Evolved format.
Oh, certainly. That damage counter manipulation has been so huge in so many different decks, especially this one, of course. But Radiant Alakazam showing up in the finals as well. If you were to rank all the Radiant Pokemon and their viability or popularity, Alakazam was definitely not up there, but I'm thinking that's going to change after this weekend.
Oh, it definitely has to. And then there is that Strafe, 30 damage, but the evolution of that Duraludon VMAX and no energy from Ian. Didn't even look at the hand. Already has that Skyscraper ability locked and loaded.
Well, Cyrus's hand isn't too great to capitalize on this, and hitting 30 damage, not going to be super helpful. That humongous 330 HP of Duraludon will be a tough mountain to climb for Cyrus, but your opponent just draw passing is certainly beneficial.
Now, Ian did say he was prepping for this finals match all last night. Could this just be the strategy, lone Duraludon VMAX?
I don't think there's any universe where this would be what Ian was scheming or planning last night. You always want to lead with this Arceus V-Star. You always want to get those double Duraludons ready. The dream would be setting up an Arceus V-Star, having two Duraludons on your bench, and that is it, forcing your opponent to play to eight prizes. But we're going to see that Karina's focus. The Inteleon is starting to get set up. And we see another pass by Ian, so that Inteleon VMAX will be able to start pressuring. And what an unfortunate situation for him.
Yeah, this has gotten a little bit rough, missing those energy cards. Now two water energy on that Inteleon VMAX. That's going to be able to just constantly deal 140 damage with that GMAX Hyrule. And you already have those basic waters to attack. Eventually, in three turns, this Duraludon VMAX is going down.
It definitely is. And if we were with the 50-minute round timer, as we do in Swiss, I would definitely be considering scooping it up as Ian. But we do have 75 minutes, so we should be able to complete a few games. Ian did get an Ultra Ball as a top deck, so we'll be able to do something different. Yeah. And that high HP is definitely troublesome for Cyrus, but after the start, you gotta be nervous if you're Ian.
Well, we do have that Ultra Ball there, like you said, off the top. Discards Lost City. And you also have to be careful of discarding Pokemon in this matchup because of that Echoing Horn that Cyrus plays. She said in the matchup video that it is one of the key cards to try to steal this matchup.
Yeah, Echoing Horn could be pretty key. Cheryl could also be pretty key, as she can eliminate some of the damage that Ian will be doing. Ian's Pokemon do a lot of damage, but they will never be able to one-shot any of Cyrus's big HP VMAXes now. There is the issue that if you play Cheryl, heal of your Inteleon, you will not be able to just attach a Rapid Strike energy to continue to do damage, which is probably something she did over the course of the weekend, but Duraludon VMAX is not affected by it, so you also get set back that turn.
Ian is debating grabbing that Lumineon V, Luminous Sign, able to search for a supporter, make this hand a little bit better, eyeing down that Adventurer's Discovery, maybe. And it looks like that is the supporter of choice. Adventurer's Discovery, search your deck for three Pokemon V, reveal them, put them in your hand. Looks like Arceus V, Arceus V, Arceus V star.
Indeed. Now, I gotta wonder if Ian actually has an energy to attach to our Arceus. We haven't seen any energies attached to the Duraludon. If you had a Darkness energy or a Dual Turner energy, you probably wouldn't attach it to the Duraludon. And there is the Darkness energy. That is why we weren't seeing the energy attachments. And those two metal that Ian prized could actually be very impactful after how this early game has developed.
And it was actually the Umbreon V, not the second Arceus V, but this puts it at a little bit of a risk. We could see a Boss's Orders KO with that Rapid Strike Urshifu VMAX if Cyrus has it available to her. You're going to see that Rapid Strike search here with Octillery. Search your deck for any Rapid Strike card and put it in your hand. Going to find that second Inteleon VMAX.
Now, Cyrus should be pretty happy with how things are developing, not because Ian had that such a slow start, but now there's plenty of Pokemon on the bench. And there are three Pokemon that are not Duraludon VMAX. So a combination of Boss's Orders, a combination of Escape Rope could allow her to clean up the board without even having to deal with Duraludon VMAX. So ideally, or rather, this is the ideal situation. Your opponent has been forced to bench a lot of different Pokemon, and that Duraludon isn't even close to being powered up just yet.
Is that the Escape Rope in hand? No, okay, I don't think it is. There's the retreat with the Tower of Waters, reducing that retreat cost of all your Rapid Strike Pokemon. And we're going to see a G-Max Rapid Flow spread 120 damage to two Pokemon each.
Yeah, exactly. Putting previous damage on the Duraludon, putting previous damage on the Umbreon. I am generally surprised that there hasn't been any damage on that Lumineon. As you know, you're going to have a pretty guaranteed amount of prizes against that Arceus V-Star with two. Then you get two more with Lumineon, and then you only have to deal with one Duraludon VMAX or potentially the Umbreon. But clearly Cyrus knows what she's doing. She is here for a reason, and we'll have to see what she has cooking up for us.
For Ian's turn, we already know, or we don't know, that the Arceus V-Star, it went to the bottom of the deck, thanks to that Iona. Does have an Ultra Ball, though, so that will be able to fetch it back out of the deck. And with that Arceus V-Star, you got access to Star Birth, that amazing ability, being able to search your deck for any two cards. We could see a way to get out of the active here, maybe even something like an Escape Rope or a Supporter.
Indeed, definitely needs to get that Duraludon VMAX out of the active. Damaging this Urshifu is actually pretty relevant. I am not seeing an actual switch in Cyrus's deck list, so because the Rapid Strike Urshifu is in the active spot, the only way for the Arceus V-Star to go down next turn would be an Escape Rope plus a Boss's Order. So not exactly an easy combination to find when you can't directly search for a specific card. There's also no space for Lumineon to search for that Boss's Order. So even though this isn't the best situation for Ian, there is starting to be a small path or a small ray of light after that horrible, horrible start.
Ultra Ball for the second time. We'll find the second Duraludon VMAX switch into that Arceus V-Star, double Turbo Energy, and then a Professor's Research for seven new cards.
Seven fresh new cards, and this is pretty smart. Using that in order to get more resources, get powered up. There's no way for Ian to heal, though, and no way to get Pokemon out of the bench. We have seen other versions of this deck play a copy of Volo, in fact, but that is not available right now. No ability used, Ian recognizes that. That Urshifu being in the active is actually not a threat. Even if it gets powered up by Melanie and a Rapid Strike Energy attachment, that is not enough to KO the Arceus V-Star.
Well, there is that Trinity Nova, 180 damage on that Rapid Strike Urshifu VMAX. Searching the deck for a couple energy, charges up that Umbreon VMAX. I'm still thinking about the last one potentially here. Having to get rid of a fighting with the Ultra Ball, it's going to put a tax on the resources left for those energies.
Now, if Melanie was available for Cyrus, a really cool play she could do is use Urshifu's second attack to 240 damage on this Arceus V-Star, place two extra damage counters with Alakazam, and then utilize Medicham V to get that extra free turn with the Yoga Loop.
Now action back to Cyrus. Does have the escape rope though, so able to get this Rapid Strike Urshifu VMAX out of the active spot. Now just needs a boss's orders and we'll be able to take the knockout on that Arceus V-Star. Also, depending on what Pokemon Ian brings up, it could be an easy knockout, something like that Umbreon VMAX, but you don't want to give up three prizes. Lumineon V brought to the active spot. Cyrus brings up that Inteleon VMAX with that water energy. And here is that Cheryl, that powerful supporter in this deck. Heal all your evolution Pokemon and discard all energy attached to them. Well, hey, if you don't have energy, you still get a free heal out of it.
Oh, certainly. Getting that damage off is essentially as if Ian hadn't had a turn, right? Or as if Ian had used Arceus V to power up instead of Arceus V-Star. So really powerful play by Cyrus, and this will allow her to get even more damage on the board, which she can manipulate through Painful Spoons. Now, attacking little minion, not super ideal if you are planning on utilizing Umbreon or KOing Umbreon and Duraludon for your six prizes, but the Yoga Loop play, getting damage on this Luminion, hitting for 140, does allow you to make sure that at some point you can use Medicham and get those free prizes.
It's 150, right?
It is 150. Yeah.
So 20 left. That would be perfect math for that Yoga Loop in the following turns. And there you have it. 150 damage on that Luminion V. Ian, just a ton of damage on the board, stacking up those dice.
Yeah, based on how aggressive Cyrus is being, I think her path to victory might be these three Pokemon. She might not need to concern herself with Duraludon VMAX, and this is mostly due to Ian's very rough start, but that's no fault of Cyrus. She's making the best of what she has right now.
I mean, you always gotta just force your opponent to play into this. If you can avoid that Duraludon VMAX, that's the best case scenario here. And it seems like with the way the cards have turned out, Cyrus is doing just that and doing it pretty well. Ian has the energy to retreat here, so we'll be able to bring up that Arceus V-Star yet again. And this is the same scenario we were kind of in beforehand, where you're not gonna be able to really bring back up that Rapid Strike Urshifu VMAX to get the full damage out of your attack, take the KO on the Arceus V-Star, especially with the escape rope already gone.
Indeed, and there's something also important to note from Cyrus's deck is that she has no boss's orders, so now that that escape rope is gone, the only way she can target down Pogo on the bench is through Urshifu's attack and those Painful Spoons damage counter movement. So we'll have to see if this ends up affecting her in some way.
One thing is that the bench is full, so you're not able to get that Medicham V down. So we're just gonna see that Painful Spoons move the damage counters, take the knockout on Lumineon V here. Cyrus going down to four prize cards here in our game one of Masters Finals for the TCG.
as we mentioned, now there's two more Pokemon left to go in order to get this win. And there's also another Arceus V right here that could potentially be targeted down. We'll have to see what the path is, but Duraludon's not a threat if it's not in the active. There's actually been no damage denial by Duraludon at this point in time.
Lost City also proving an interesting stadium in this match, because as long as it sticks in play, if Ian gets a Pokemon knocked out, like that Lumineon, it's going to a Lost Zone. You can't Echoing Horn that back.
Yep, not having that available for Echoing Horn is actually pretty important. Cyrus does have access to Tower of Waters at any point she needs to with that Octillery. However, yeah, not having that easier knockout on the Lumineon, even though Arceus is weak to fighting, if it's not in the active, that's not relevant, so it's an extra 50 HP that she has to go through.
And we see that Echoing Horn there bring up that Umbreon V. A little off screen there for you. And here we have Energy Retrieval, being able to get two waters, or just the one water, to be able to attack here. And we're going to see another G-Max Rapid Flow.
Probably
20 damage to two Pokemon yet again.
Yep, but it's 240 to the active since Arceus V-Star is weak to fighting. And there's the plan for Cyrus, these two Pokemon ready to be knocked out with Painful Spoons. You can also get them closer. And this is where Inteleon VMAX's ability starts to be even more relevant. However, Cyrus is in a little bit of a drought of water energy.
Yeah, we are used to seeing her have just as many as she wants, but only that one available throughout the beginning stages of this game one here. Still able to put in a ton of work, has that one stuck on that Inteleon VMAX on the bench.
Indeed, she'd probably love to use that as a way to put more damage onto the bench, as right now with no Duraludon VMAX in the active, you can easily use Rapid Strike energy to take this KO. But this is the perfect situation for a Yuga loop play. We have Radiant Alakazam, which could potentially move two damage counters onto this Arceus, and then we have the Yuga loop perfectly set up, and then all that needs to be done is knock out this Umbreon, or even this Arceus, or the Umbreon that's off screen in order to be able to finish out the game, to the point where she's even healing Ian's Duraludon. Look at that.
Who would have thought, helping out your opponent there? But no, this is exactly what Cyrus wants to accomplish. Being able to just steal an extra turn with that Yoga loop is something that we haven't really seen a lot of just in the format in general. Medicham V is a very powerful Pokemon with that attack, but it takes a very dedicated deck to accomplish that. And there's that Tower of Waters. Now you're able to free retreat into that Medicham V, and Cyrus is going to be able to take another turn.
Yep, there's the Yoga loop. So a free turn for Cyrus. Not a lot of help from the prize cards, and by being down to two, an Iona from Ian could prove detrimental, but Umbreon VMAX has how much HP remaining? 70. You can also move two damage counters from Duraludon onto it. You can even Yoga loop onto it again and make sure that it's very, very close. Any sort of water energy would be helpful, and there's the little bit of help.
Well, you can't Yoga loop this turn. If you use Yoga loop, the turn or prior, not able to use it again. Otherwise, we'd just be taking a bunch of extra turns here in this game.
That's true. Now, we do have the Melanie fetching two more water energies and powering up Medicham V for a smash uppercut, doing 200 damage to this Arceus V-Star. So now we have another route to potentially win, and there's the first Inteleon VMAX ability, putting extra damage and extra pressure on the Umbreon.
Double gunner, having 40 damage on that Umbreon VMAX, 40 damage on that Duraludon VMAX. Painful Spoons moves another 20 to that Umbreon. That is a lot of dice, Pablo.
One damage counter is what separates this game right now. That's any water energy or the Alakazam moving one more damage. So Ian's plan might be to Lost City away or just KO that Radiant Alakazam, but then just any water energy does the trick.
that opens up a lot of options for Cyrus. I believe I already saw the Clara in her hand. That is exactly what you would need to be able to take that knockout and seal up this game one.
Smash uppercut gets utilized. That is definitely an attack. If we rarely see Yoga Loop, unless it's in this archetype, using smash uppercut, that is certainly not common. I don't think I've ever seen that on stream before myself.
Never seen on stream. I played a little bit with it, but you got to do what you got to do. And it's another fighting attacker against this Arceus V-Star, against this Umbreon VMAX. And it's working. It's working, and it's working pretty well.
Now, I made sure to do a little bit of math check on myself earlier. I worked on my multiplication tables, and I'm pretty sure this Umbreon is about to go down, and there it is. Cyrus Davis takes game one. Wow, what a game.
What a game indeed. 20 minutes down, we are moving on to game two, and Cyrus Davis is one game away from being our international champion here today. Ian Rob is going to have to put in a lot of work. That confidence needs to show itself here. Two games to try and win this tournament. Already at the back foot, but you have to just forget about that start, right?
Yep.
You didn't do anything for the first two, three turns of the game. Game two is a whole new game. Anything can happen.
I think there's definitely a big mental aspect to playing Pokemon at the highest level and being able to understand that each game is individual and separate from each other. Just because this happened once doesn't mean it's going to continually happen or you have to make any big adjustments. Things didn't go to plan for Ian. Now he gets to go first. And as long as he finds Arceus plus energy, we've been saying it all weekend, get Arceus plus energy, you're feeling great. Don't get that, that's when things start spiraling out of control, as we just saw.
That is what we're going to have to look for, Arceus plus energy. Looks like we got a broken sleeve, easily fixed. Back to the shuffling here, and Ian has a troubled history with Inteleon VMAX, has tried it at a regionals or two, not had the best finish, and maybe karma's come knocking here. Finds himself down one game against the unlikely VMAX Pokemon.
Yep, I love how both players were super confident. Both players still look very confident. Yeah, Ian looks very, very calm. He's smiling. He knows this happened. Sure, I'm one game down. But on paper, I should have the advantage because of Duraludon. It's just a matter of not benching too many Pokemon. As we saw, there were two Duraludon VMAXs in play. That doesn't matter if there's other Pokemon that can go down at the same time, especially something as a low HP Luminion V, which Ian was unfortunately forced to bench in order to be able to continue to play the game at all.
Oh, that looked like an amazing hand for Cyrus, but no basic Pokemon. Going to have to mulligan here, and wow, two medals prized yet again for Ian.
Two medals prized could come into play once again as you try to power up not one, but two Duraludon VMAXs. These Arcpile decks are playing a lot of different Pokemon, a lot of different types. But you only have so many energies you can play, right? And the more spread out your Pokemon are, the thinner your lines are of your energy, then it's going to be harder to power up two of the same Pokemon. One is always going to be a given, but two of them could be problematic. But thankfully, the energies are at the bottom of the prizes.
Energies are at the bottom. Cyrus prizes, that one of Escape Rope might prove a little troublesome. Ian starts that Arceus V for this game two. Has a nest ball. We'll be able to search out a Pokemon here. I think I see another Arceus V, but the real question, we've been saying it time and time again, is there an energy?
That's the big question. I couldn't tell from his hand. I do believe I see a metal energy, which is great because it's Arceus plus energy, but it's awful when there's two more metal energy prized. Ian plays a total of four. So if that energy goes into the Arceus, until Ian takes a prize card, Duraludon VMAX will not be able to be powered up at all.
That is huge, and that's why you see Ian being so deliberate in looking for those prize cards, making sure what resources you have available to you, and if he doesn't have another type of energy in the hand, we could see a pretty insane game two here.
I think if you're Ian, like, this is close to worst case scenario, potentially. Having to attach that metal, there's not going to be the possibility for Drawl and VMAX to attack until one of them is freed up on the prizes. I don't think you ever pass up on attaching the energy because that would immediately hinder you. But Ian definitely knows that there's two metal energies prized at this point in time.
I got a glimpse at Cyrus's hand. It is that battle VIP pass that she just played, but also an Irida and a Ultra Ball. This is going to be an explosive turn one from this Rapid Strike deck.
The dream combination, going second, Irida is such a powerful card, gets you a Remoraid, gets you an Inteleon, and also that Val VIP path to just establish anything else you could possibly want. Important thing is to know if there's a follow-up to that, right? But if that is the case, then, oh wow, Ultra Ball away the Irida. What else is in the hand? Okay, goes for the Luminion. So maybe just trying to get a stronger diversity.
We're going for Melanie here. Oh. Discarded the water energy with the Ultra Ball means Melanie will be able to accelerate that to the Inteleon if wanted. But I also think we're going to accelerate it to the Rapid Strike Urshifu. There's a Rapid Strike energy in hand. As long as she has Tower of Waters, that would be able to take the knockout on the Arceus V.
This is a big, big play by Cyrus.
Was that the last card?
The Tower of Waters, I don't see it.
Oh, it was another Rapid Strike energy.
Yeah, so no turn one KO on that Arceus, unfortunately. I know that was possibility. Tower of Waters was prized, right? One of the three copies in the deck. So less likely, but still, these high-level plays, when you're one game ahead, you can take that risk for sure. You don't need to play as conservative. It was a big risk, didn't pay off immediately, but you still have your Urshifu powered up, ready to start striking down next turn.
And there we have that attachment of the Rapid Strike energy to that benched Rapid Strike Urshifu V, setting up for big KO on a potential Arceus V-Star, which Ian is essentially just telegraphing. You have to go into Arceus V-Star to charge up your Duraludon.
Yeah, there's no way you don't do that, but the energies getting attached this turn to the Duraludon might give Cyrus indication that there's no more metal energies available. There is access to Right Hand by Ian, which is potentially a way to power up that Duraludon VMAX after the Arceus goes down. And the two metal energies are, thankfully for Ian, at the very bottom. But if they weren't, this could get really tricky really quickly.
A little bit of an awkward draw off that Iono for Cyrus. Looks like a bunch of Pokemon and a couple energies. Now Ian does have that double turbo energy. He's going to use that Star Birth V-Star power here from Arceus V-Star. Finds the Choice Belt. That will allow Ian to take a knockout on one of these Pokemon V.
Yeah, get ahead by two prizes right now against an Inteleon. Also denying an Inteleon from Cyrus is pretty important here, so she can cycle through them as she tries to go through the Duraludon VMAX. And the big issue that Ian has right now is that two Duraludon VMAXs being powered up are definitely off the table, so there will need to be another Pokemon being powered up at some point in the game, probably an Umbreon VMAX to force your opponent to play to eight prizes. However, its damage output is a little less good than Arceus V-Star, but the big thing is that it's not weak to fighting, which Arceus is.
Looks like off the Starburst, it was that Choice Belt, and then possibly a supporter for next turn. Trinity Nova takes the knockout, charges up that Duraludon VMAX with one energy piece, and that Dark. Going to be a little awkward, but hey, it thins the deck out to try to draw what you need. And Ian really needs to find those basic metal energies from the prize card. Thankfully, he'll be able to grab both of them as they were down at the bottom.
Indeed. Now, Ian being very, very careful, the other card that he grabbed was, in fact, Raihan, which, knowing that this Arceus could potentially go down this turn, Raihan would allow you to get that metal energy onto the Duraludon, but you can't expect a misplay of the sword by Ian. You just have to know that there's no more metal energies available at this point in time.
And now we see Cyrus here evolve that Rapid Strike Urshifu V into the VMAX, but it's not going to be able to take the knockout on the Arceus V-Star anymore. just 240 damage. You can't damage that bench Duraludon VMAX, even though you discarded that special energy. It happens before.
Exactly. There is a very specific order in which damage, KOs, effective attacks are calculated, and because of that, it's not possible to damage that Duraludon, even though you're discarding. However, Duraludon VMAX is finally powered up. Cyrus might be a little puzzled why that energy didn't come down to the Duraludon beforehand. It must have been either all of them in the hand or from the prize cards, but now Ian in a much, much better situation than he was before.
And Cyrus top decking the professor's research here. Otherwise, this hand was not doing too hot. You have that Cheryl to be able to heal this Rapid Strike Urshifu VMAX, but there was no other energy, no other supporters, so you can still go for the Cheryl play here, and then next turn, have a big professor's research.
Yeah, it does allow you to heal. It does mean you will take a more of a passive turn, if you will. Now, if the research was the top deck and the Tower of Waters was in hand before that, why did we not promote a Pokemon and take a knockout on the Arceus V-Star last turn? I am a little bit puzzled by that.
Well, it looks like we'll have to see. Lost City is going to bump that Tower of Waters. And Ian has everything he really needs. That Duraludon VMAX powered up. His Arceus V-Star has taken two prizes and is possibly about to take two more. Meaning Ian Robb just one more knockout away from tying things up here in this Masters Finals.
Exactly. What a difference Arceus plus energy makes, right? It's make or break for these Arceus decks. With that, it has been since Arceus's release. Arceus actually used to play Melanie itself to help with that powering up, help with getting energy on board. But the big difference is this, the lack of benched Pokemon for Ian. There's nothing else to be damaged, nothing else to be targeted, no way to spread damage around. And there's also no Radiant Alakazam on Cyrus's side of the board. But even then, yeah, Ian got what he needed, and we're starting to see Cyrus's setup crumble just a little bit.
Ultra Ball does find that Umbreon V, and with Trinity Nova, we'll be able to charge it up. Taking the knockout, Ian going down to two prize cards here, game two.
Now there's the Radiant Alakazam that we were talking about. There's the Professor's Research, so a fresh new hand for Cyrus. Octillery would be fantastic. Rapid Strike Energy would be fantastic. Even though Urshifu won't be throwing the maximum amount of damage with its first attack, it will quite simply take the KO through weakness, allowing Cyrus to take her first two prizes. But the big card not being available here, I think, is the Tower of Waters. One being prized, one in the Discard Ball. That could spell a little bit of trouble as we advance this game.
Rapid Strike Search off that Octillery that was found off Professor's Research does find a second Inteleon VMAX here. It looks like Cyrus already has another one in hand. So we'll be able to get both those in play. Hopefully a couple double gunners. Already had it in play.
Indeed. Now, Ian does not have an easy target to pick off with the Umbreon VMAX Dark Signal ability. We are going to see a little bit of damage manipulation here, and now it's time to damage this Duraludon, because as long as Ian doesn't bench anything else, Cyrus will have to go through it. There is a possibility to use Echoing Horn at some point in the match, but right now you need to damage it as much as you can, as you're going to be dealing at most 140 damage with G-Max Spiral onto it.
And with not searching for that Rapid Strike energy, not going to be able to attack. So just attaches a basic water to the second Inteleon VMAX and passes the turn, knowing this Rapid Strike Urshifu VMAX in the active spot cannot be taken out in one hit.
It absolutely cannot be taken out in one hit, but until something goes down, the Yoga Loop play is not available for Cyrus. Her whole bench is full, therefore there's no cute way to knock out this Arceus V-Star. It will have to be attacked at some point or KO'd through Radiant Alakazam, but until Ian ends up taking a knockout, there will be no Yoga Loop coming from Cyrus.
Trinity Nova yet again, 210 damage thanks to that Choice Belt. Cyrus drew a Water Energy for the turn, attaches it to that Inteleon VMAX, so now she'll be able to attack if she has the way out of the active. It's going to start things off with an Iona, though.
Indeed, Iona very powerful here, getting rid of that Umbreon VMAX with a Dark Signal ability, which could immediately hunt down that Rapidstrike Urshifu VMAX. But until we see the Tower of Waters, that Urshifu VMAX will be staying there. I think she did draw it.
Yeah, it's in the hand. They're going to use that Ultra Ball to thin out a little bit more. Did have to discard that Octillery, but finds that Medicham V just so you don't draw into it in the following turns.
Yep, thinning your deck, very, very important. Getting all the cards that you don't want to draw out of your deck. And grabbing that Echoing Horn.
Yeah, one thing I always forget. Echoing Horn is a rapid strike card. You can search for it with Octillery.
I was definitely very confused for a second there. I thought we were Forest Steel Stone foring it. But there's a Tower of Waters. We will be able to retreat. And so it's an Ian. Did he find one of the three copies of Boss's Orders? Any Ultra Ball does the trick as well. It's all about Umbreon VMAX to chase down Urshifu wherever it goes.
Already used that copy of Chiral to heal off the damage once already. Cyrus does have energy retrieval though, so we'll be able to double gunner twice here. Spread 80 more damage.
Jeez, these Pokemon have so much HP, Jeremy. 330, even 200 feels a little out of reach for Cyrus right now. There's a knockout on the Arceus V-Star. But right. Now, the
Boss's Orders, Ultra Ball. There's that Boss's Orders. Ian Robb tying things up here in finals. We're going to a game three, Pablo.
We are going to a game three. What the players wanted, what the crowd wants, what we want. Very exciting series so far. And now Cyrus gets to go first. And she did say in her interview that she felt very confident going first. And I have to think, because she can chase down the Arceus V at some point. If she can deny that Arceus V with the energy that Ian's going to be looking for, then the setup crumbles, right?
Yeah, this is where maybe Ian doesn't want to start Arceus V, so you can have it on the bench. Keep it safe from the no Boss's Orders in Cyrus's deck.
Indeed, and Boss's Orders, not such a big deal. On turn two, has it. Well, I guess there's Luminion to search for it, but yeah, you might not know there's no Boss's Order. You might expect one in the list, perhaps, and Escape Rope is searchable through Irida. So Ian will be trying not to start the Arceus, but potentially benching two at once, or even any other Pokemon that can be not the Arceus V.
Then that lends to the strategy, though, where you just ignore the Duraludon VMAXs and go after those multiple Arceus V, use that Echoing Horn in combination, and try to take the game by just avoiding that big Skyscraper.
Indeed, the dream start for Ian would be Duraludon in the active, Arceus V in the bench, Duraludon on the bench, but realistically, with so few copies of the Duraludon, with all these other Pokemon, Umbreon, Spiritomb, Radiant Alakazam, even Luminion V, that's not gonna be easy. And if you're forced to even bench two Arceus V, that could be very problematic, as then Cyrus only needs to deal with one Duraludon VMAX.
This is going to be the most important opening hands for both of these players in their Pokemon career so far. Looks like both players found a Pokemon. Take a look at the prize cards.
Only one Metal Energy. The prize is this time one copy of Duraludon VMAX, however. So setting up two is going to be difficult, and we do have the Arceus V start for Ian. No battle VIP pass for Cyrus this time around, though.
No battle VIP pass, but that Rapid Strike energy and that Rapid Strike Urshifu V is exactly what Cyrus wants to try to take down this Arceus V. And oh, wow. Is that a Professor's Research and then Trinity Charge? Could we see a winner right here? Cyrus
no
has the Octillery.
Way.
Rapid Strike Search for the Tower Waters.
It's
attaches
over?
The Water Energy.
It's
and
over?
100 blows. Cyrus Davis is your North American International Champion with Rapid Strike Inteleon VMAX Urshifu VMAX.
What just happened? We were just looking at the prize cards and the game was barely over. Ian, I had never seen a Professor's Research replayed so fast, and he found no Nesquall, no Ultra Ball, and no other Pokemon.
The two wins Cyrus were able to take down, and just not having that optimal turn one. But that does not matter. What matters is being able to call yourself an international champion. Congratulations again to Cyrus Davis and, of course, Ian Robb. Second place at the biggest tournament we've ever had. That's not too shabby.
Welcome back to the stage, your North American international champion. Congratulations, Cyrus. How are you feeling?
I don't even know how I'm feeling. I just cried. I'm all emotional. I am wiped. I cannot believe what just happened in those three games. I don't even really remember them at this point. I'm elated. This means everything to me.
Let's go back through the games, because in the first game, you know, Ian had been saying, if you go second, it's over. But it wasn't. Tell us about that game.
I mean, Ian started to rally on. He attached past. I mean, I can't really say much more than that's just how it goes sometimes. Like, it really was unfortunate draws game one and game three for Ian. That really saved me there. I felt like I was 45-55 going second. And sort of got bailed out by that, I'll be honest.
But then in game three, I looked away from the screen for a second, and then the game was over. Tell us about that.
Yeah, I mean, I tried to go for game two, the turn one Melanie or Shifu play. I had six outs in deck, the tower or four seal stone for it. I didn't hit it. And then game three, he just went Arceus, attach pass. I go take my turn, he goes attach pass. And I'm like, well, I look at my hand, and I'm like, if there's not three Tower of Waters in this deck right now, and the prize is, I'm an international champion.
And you are. Tell us, that title is yours forever, and you get to go to Worlds. How does both of those facts feel?
I've been playing this game for a long time, and I never thought I would get to this level of accomplishment, and it makes my 10 years plus of playing feel like it was all leading up to something.
Yes, it was. There are a lot of people out here cheering for you, and I'm sure a lot who have watched you on that journey. Do you want to say anything to them?
I love all of my Canadian friends. I'm so glad Canada has now won an international championship. Ontario, Canada is the best region in the world. Three of us were on top eight. One loss to another one on the winning end. Do not underestimate Canada.
Great advice. All right, let's hear it one more time for Cyrus and Casters. We'll head back to you.